we all know how Putana, on the orders of Kamsa, came to Vrindavan, came to Gokul, to kill Krishna. So how did she come? She came in the form of a very beautiful young woman and approached Yashoda Mai, saying that, "Oh, yeah, I heard you have got a newborn baby. So I just came to, you know, see your child, and I want to nurse him with my milk." And that is how she came, and she lifted Krishna on her lap and she started feeding her milk to him. But then what had she done? She had actually smeared a deadly poison on her breasts with the intention that when Krishna will suck her nipple, at that time he will, that poison will go into his mouth and he will be killed. This was whole Putana's intention. But then what happened?
Shri Krishna Balaram ki.
Krishna sucked her milk, and at the same time he sucked her prana, her life breath also, out of her body, and she was killed. So remembering this incident, the matter actually did not end there. So remembering this incident, he, Uddhava, said, "Aho Baki." So he was referring to Putana as Baki, because Baka was another asura who later came in the form of a bird to kill Krishna. Putana was the younger sister of Baka, and therefore her another name was Baki. Putana's another name was Baki. So he said, Uddhava said, "Aho Baki, this Putana, she came and she offered her breast to Lord Krishna. Jigamsayanto apayayat." She apayat, she fed her milk to Krishna. Jigamsanto, thinking that her intention was to kill Krishna. So although she appeared like a very, very motherly woman trying to kill Krishna, trying to feed Krishna, api asadvi, she was actually a very wicked, cruel woman. So what happened? "Aho Baki stanakala kootam jigamsapayad." So she came with an intention to kill Krishna. Api asadvi, such a cruel, wicked woman she was, because earlier also she was used to killing small children. So can you imagine, small babies, somebody has a fetish to kill small young kids, young infants. So how much cruel and wicked that person must be. So she was an asadvi, but she came as if apayer, she came as if she wanted to feed her milk to Krishna in a motherly manner. So what did Krishna do? Krishna, he killed her, and while killing her, what did he do? After killing her, what did he do? "Lebhire dhatri gatim." Lebhire gatim dhatri uchitam. She obtained the position of dhatri to Krishna. She obtained the position of a nurse of Krishna in Goloka as an assistant to Yashoda Mai. So Uddhava, remembering this incident, that despite Putana coming to Krishna with an intention to kill him, she had no motherly loving affection towards Krishna. Her only intention was to kill. Jigamsayato, she just wanted to kill Krishna. And asadvi, she was totally a wicked woman. But what did Krishna do? He gave her lebhire gatim dhatri uchitam. He gave her the position of a nurse in Goloka Vrindavan. "Tato anyam kam dayalum sharanam vrajema." Uddhava says that Krishna is such a dayalu that which other person sharanam vrajema can I take shelter of, who can be as merciful, as compassionate, as such a great personality that Krishna is. That even to a person who came to kill Krishna, he gave her the position of his nurse, almost the position of his mother in the spiritual world. So Krishna feels compassion towards other living entities. Krishna, even though Putana came with an intention to kill Krishna, Krishna saw, after all, she fed me her milk. Even though she came with an intention to kill me, still she fed me her milk, So I'll give her the position of a nurse in the spiritual world. So you see how Krishna is so compassionate. Any normal person within this material world, if somebody comes to kill him, he will never show him any compassion. The first opportunity he gets, he will kill him and finish him off, that's all. But Krishna is so compassionate, he is thinking, beyond what she tried to kill me, he is thinking, she fed me her milk, so she is as good as my mother. So Krishna feels compassion. Actually, Krishna's compassion is very strongly expressed in this material world. The whole Bhagavad Gita, if you see, everywhere you can see, every verse you can see Krishna's compassion and Krishna's love. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that Aham Bija Pradaha Pita Sarva Yonishu Kaunteya. So Krishna is actually saying, Kaunteya, I am the father of all the living entities. All the living entities who are there in this world are my children. Krishna is saying with so much love and affection. And Krishna, when Krishna is saying, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Raja Aham Stvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayishyami. Krishna is saying, you give up everything else and surrender to me. I will take care of you. Don't worry. All your past, whatever you have done, you have gone against me. You have done so many offenses, so many sinful activities. You have worked against me. Forget all those things. I'll forget. I'll forgive. I'll take care of you. Please, please come and surrender unto me. See Krishna's compassion. Krishna is saying, just come and say, I surrender to you. I'll forget all the past. I will completely erase all the past. Whatever you have done, everything you have done, I will erase. Imagine, can the government say something like that? Criminal, if he comes to the court and says, I am sorry, I made a mistake, I did this, I am surrendering to the court. Then immediately court will say, okay, if that is the case, I will forgive everything, forget everything. No punishment for you. You are free. You can go back. Will the government ever say? No. The moment you confess, they'll say, confession mil gaya na, dala usko. Put the biggest this one on him. Because that's the nature of this material world. But Krishna is so loving, so compassionate. A person just says, Krishna, durbuddhi, I went against you. I'm sorry, whatever I did, please forgive me. Krishna will say, okay, you have said, sorry, no, bhool gaye, everything forgotten. Everything forgotten. I will forgive you for everything that you have done in the past. I'll forget everything. New chapter, I'll take you back to Godhead. This is Krishna's compassion.